What's up, you guys? Welcome back again to your HeroClix headquarters. Today, we've got the awesome new Peacemaker on the Wings of Eagly Iconix set. And man, I've been really looking forward to this one ever since watching the show. One of the first things I thought was, I cannot wait till we get some HeroClix of this show. So the fact that we actually did is actually pretty crazy, but it's crazy awesome. So without further ado, let's check this out. As always, all these Iconix have like a little window with a little Velcro here. You can pop open so you can actually kind of see everything you're getting there, and of course kind of explains what's in it and stuff. So yeah, let's cut the tape here and check it out. All right, so here you can see you get six figures and all their cards. And I will point out right away that, as you can see here, there is no equipment object. However, we do get a card for an equipment with this set. So we'll take a look at that here in a second. So starting us off with Peacemaker, he's got Suicide Squad Team Ability, Suicide Squad Assassin, Martial Artist, and Soldier keywords. And he's got a trait, Special Helmets. If Peacemaker is equipped with a Peacemaker helmet, when he uses its effect, he may choose a result instead of rolling. So we'll take a look at the equipment in a moment. But basically you roll and it gets you a random result of a different effect you can use. And then he has a special attack power in the middle of his dial that says Energy Explosion, Penetrating Psychic Blast. When Peacemaker uses Energy Explosion, attack rolls of 10 and higher are critical hits. That's pretty great. That's going to be penetrating as well from the penetrating blast. So, wow. I kind of wish he started with that. For 70 points, that would have been pretty nice. But yeah, I mean, 6 movement running shot, 6 range, 12 attack precision, 18 toughness, 3 damage with a special damage power that we'll take a look at here, which gives him outwit and probability control. That's a pretty great combo. And I love the back of his card here with John Cena on there. Very awesome. So yeah, really cool. Good dial overall. Randomly gets up to like a 4 damage a couple clicks in. So yeah, not bad at all. And then we'll take a quick look at his equipment, which is Peacemaker's helmet. And it has indestructible name or keywords is Peacemaker, so you can equip it to any Peacemaker. So we are getting another one in the next Iconix set that comes out pretty soon here next month. And then we also, of course, have the old Peacemaker from, I think it was Batman Team Up. So any of those can get this helmet for free, which is great. But it has the effect to free and roll a d6. The equipped character can use the resulting effect until your next turn. So it's similar to the Batman utility belt, except instead of like turning it on the card to like select a random thing, it just depends on whatever you roll. So on a 1, screwdriver gives you invulnerability. On a 2, anti-gravity gives you flight and sidestep. On a 3, X-ray vision gives you improved targeting for hindering and destroy blocking. That's crazy. On a 4, sonic boom gives you knockback and pulse wave. On a 5, scabies for all gives you poisoned and can deal penetrating damage when they use it. And then a 6, choose any other result. That's hilarious. So you got all of his helmets from the show there. And the fact that this Peacemaker can choose any of those results is amazing. So if you need flight and sidestep to get around, or if you need to see through a wall to shoot somebody behind it, you know, you got those options. You can get invuln his whole dial, or just knockback pulse wave, which is such a strong combo because the knockback can't be reduced either because it's all their powers are turned off from the pulse wave. So very, very strong. So yeah, that Peacemaker is freaking awesome. Next up, we have Eagly, who has the Suicide Squad and Animal keywords and the Suicide Squad team ability. Coming in at just 30 points, makes a nice even 100 points with Peacemaker. He has power. If no other characters have been placed this turn, choose an opposing character that damaged a friendly character with a Suicide Squad keyword since your last turn. Place Eagly such that he can make a close attack targeting the chosen character, then do so. So he is basically just a retaliation piece. It's power action instead of free, but yeah, retaliations are always pretty good. You got flight, hypersonic, blades with an 11 attack, 18 super senses, and he's actually tiny sized despite the fact that he's like a gigantic bald eagle. And again, the back of the card looks awesome. Support as free, but only if Eagly KO'd an opposing character this turn. So that's actually pretty interesting. I think this was errated to be a damage power, though I'm just noticing it's a trait. He does have a special damage power on here. I think it should be the support one. But yeah, not bad at all for 30 points. Hypersonic blades, or, you know, just retail with the blades, KO something, and then free support on somebody would be great. But next up we have John Economos, and this guy may be actually one of my favorite figures of the set. I think he's really awesome. Argus, Suicide Squad, and Scientist keywords. Again, Suicide Squad team ability. I think they might all have Suicide Squad team ability. Yeah, they do. But he starts off with a trait that gives him power: remove all hack tokens from friendly characters. Then give a hack token to a friendly character within range. So he doesn't need line of fire. He's got 6 range. The character with the hack token can use shape change. When that character uses it and succeeds after resolutions, you may deal 1 penetrating damage to an opposing character. So that's amazing. Not only does it give shape change, but when it succeeds, you get to deal a penetrating damage to an opposing character. Like, just any opposing character. Doesn't have to be next to them, within range of them. Just any of them. Doesn't have to be the one that attacked them. Whichever one you want. That's crazy. Then he also has a special damage power that gives him perplex and probability control. And when he uses either, he may target the character with the hack token regardless of range and line of fire. Again, super powerful. So this guy is just a really, really good support figure for like one specific character on your team. Which, you know, for this is probably best that it's Peacemaker, but having the Scientist keyword immediately made me think of Prime Spider-Man. Prime Spider-Man, of course, one of my all-time favorite figures, so they're both scientists. If this guy was to give Spider-Man the hack token, he would have super senses on a 4-6, impervious, that can't be outwitted also on top of it, and then also shape change that if he succeeds deals a penetrating damage to somebody, and then he can get perplexed and probbed across the map from this guy. So yeah, that sounds like a fun combo to me. If only Kong wasn't so strong right now. Shape change kind of doesn't matter because he has Battle Fury and he just gets through all that. But besides Kong existing, it still seems like a strong combo to me. But otherwise, he just has Stealth and Mastermind to help keep him safe in the back while he hacks everything, and gets some charge blades there at the back half of his dial because he runs in there to save the day with the freaking chainsaw to chainsaw the gorilla in half. Not Kong, probably, but maybe. That would be awesome. But anyway, moving on next, we have Abadeo. I think in the show it was Adebayo. I don't remember. I feel like maybe they might have misspelled that. I don't know. It's been a minute, and maybe I was just hearing it wrong. Who knows? Anyway, she's got Suicide Squad and Spy keywords. Power, modify speed +3, improved movement, blocking, elevated in characters. Move her in a direct path up to her speed value. After resolutions, make a close attack targeting each opposing character she moved through that action. Regardless of adjacency, hit characters are dealt 1 penetrating damage instead of normal damage. From that episode where she just put on that human torpedo helmet and just, you know, flew through all the big monster things, alien things, whatever they were. That was pretty funny. And then, yeah, stealth, precision strike, willpower. But she's got another trait that says friendly characters with the Suicide Squad team ability may use that team ability to heal when any friendly character is KO'd anywhere on the map. Because normally it would be when an adjacent friendly character is KO'd, you would roll a d6 and heal them equal to the result, -2, -1. But they don't actually have to be adjacent with her, so that's pretty great. You don't have to stay all clumped up that way to get some healing. But then you also have a special damage power that gives her empower and enhancement, and adjacent friendly characters with the Suicide Squad keyword modify attack +1. So she's going to be really great to help, you know, stay next to Peacemaker, modify his attack and damage +1. And he can even carry her around if he picks the flight and sidestep option, so that's pretty freaking awesome. And then you have Vigilante up next. He's got the Suicide Squad team ability and keyword, as well as Assassin and Martial Artist. And then he's got a trait that he starts the game with a mask token, and he can use shape change, but succeeds on a 3-6. And if he has a mask token, when he uses it and fails, remove his mask token. So he will have shape change normally, all the time, but if he has that mask token, it'll succeed on a 3-6, and if he fails it, then he removes the mask token. So that's a really strong, you know, defense there. Again, except against Kong, because Battle Fury. But yeah, you got stealth, free, place Vigilante adjacent to a terrain marker within range. That's pretty cool, actually. As long as you have a few random terrain markers spaced out, it kind of gives him like a type of running shot, but placement is always better than moving. So yeah, I got some blades, range combat expert, so good up close or at range. And then he's got some combat reflexes to go with the stealth and the super shape change. So he's going to be really annoying to hit for only 50 points too. And then late dial, he gets some penetrating blasts, an energy shield deflection, and a special damage power that gives him exploit weakness. And when he hits, modify his damage plus one if one or more of the hit characters damaged a friendly character since your last turn. That's really cool. Kind of like a, you know, vengeance type thing. Yeah, and with penetrating blast and exploit, again, he's deadly close or at range. Last but not least, we've got Harcourt, who has Suicide Squad team ability, Argus, Suicide Squad, Martial Artist, Police, Soldier, and Spy keywords. Coming in at 80 or 50 points, I think she's the only one here with a split dial. She's got Team Leader, which gives her leadership. When she uses it after resolutions, you may move a friendly character with the Suicide Squad keyword up to half the result. So that's freaking awesome to get some more mobility on the team. Then you've got Sidestep, Running Shot, and Stealth top dial, as well as 12 attack, penetrating blast, super senses, outwit, or if you're at 50 points, she's got Range Combat Expert. So she'll still have a 12 attack for 3 damage. Not bad. So yeah, you guys, that's pretty much it for this unboxing. I think all these figures look great. The sculpts are really awesome. The dials are all great too. There's a lot of really good stuff here. They make a really awesome team together. I think they all work together really well. So you kind of have like a team ready to go right out of the box, which is always nice. And I noticed if you play Harcourt at the low dial, you actually have like just under 300 points. It's like 295 points ready to go right out of the box, which is great. You know, you can put the helmet on Peacemaker for free. You still got 5 points to throw on some other equipment on somebody, maybe, if you want to. Like, maybe Bucky's arm on Vigilante would be good or something like that. So, yeah, there's a lot of really good stuff here. I think they represent all the characters from the show really well, which is, of course, one of the most important things. But to do it in a way that is actually a good dial, too, is always great. So, yeah, I like this set a lot. If you're a fan of the show, I definitely recommend picking this up. The only thing that sucks about it is we didn't get an actual helmet equipment object. You know, maybe if you could have stuck a little thing right up here somewhere, I don't know. But that would have been nice to have. It's not really a big deal. You can, you know, you technically use any random piece of terrain or something or an old object or whatever to say that's where it is on the map if you ever drop it, because you don't really need it otherwise. So that's kind of the only negative thing in my opinion. Like I said, everything else is great. The sculpts look great. The dials are great. So yeah, I think it's still a really, really awesome set. And that equipment is really good. Even if you're not named Peacemaker, you know, for 10 points to throw that on somebody, it is a little random, but pretty much all of those options are really, really good. So I wouldn't mind getting any of them at any given time. But as always, let me know all your thoughts and opinions about it in the comments below, because I'd love to talk about it with you guys there. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to smash the like button, because it does help me out a lot. And don't forget to click that subscribe button so you don't miss any future videos. But if you'd like to help support the channel even more, you can also check the links in the description for the Patreon, so you can see your name here in the credits with all these other awesome people, and for as little as $1 a month, get entered into my monthly giveaways. So make sure to check that out. But that's going to do it for this one, you guys. Thanks again so much for watching. Till next time, this has been HeroClix Headquarters, signing off.